Welcome everybody, I'm Alexander Linz, head of content of WatchAdvisor.com. On the occasion of the opening of the Panerai boutique here in Zurich on the Bahnhofstrasse, with me is the boss himself, Jean-Marc Pontroué, who is the boss of the CEO of Panerai. Jean-Marc, it's a pleasure to have you, first of all. Thank you for giving me the time.
My pleasure.
Last time we talked was in Geneva in January.
Yes.
And it was some months after you took over Panerai, and I asked you the question, you're steering a big boat now. And now it's 6 months later or 7 months later. How do you feel as a captain? Better?
Well, I was not bad in January, so I feel the
different.
Same in January. Well, I did a couple of hundreds of thousands of kilometers in the world to open new stores, to meet all the teams, which I didn't meet when we were together in January. Now I have a very good picture of where we are with Panerai. Happy to open this new store here, like we have opened many of them the last couple of months.
Can you name some of the major cities where you have opened boutiques?
Well, we have opened in China 5 more stores recently.
Okay.
We have reopened Tokyo. We have in Hong Kong opened 2 new stores in downtown Hong Kong. We'll soon open the airport of Hong Kong. We are after opening also a couple of stores in Middle East. We have opened Mall of the Emirates in Dubai. Rome months ago, which was a missing capital city in our network. We have opened a couple of key cities in our network where we are today at about 85 stores in the world for Panerai.
85 Panerai boutiques or
boutiques.
Boutiques.
No, no, boutiques.
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 Plus the retailers.
Plus the retailers,
okay.
Exactly.
Okay. But you're more or less focusing to open up more brand-owned boutiques to be able to show the entire
environment of the brand. Well, we open our own stores, but in parallel, we will open even more stores with some of our historical trade partners.
Okay.
So like this one here in Zurich, where we open this operation with our long-lasting partner, which is Embassy, which is supporting the brand from its very beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And that is an operation they are managing for us here in Zurich.
Jean-Marc, when I ask you after hearing many, many voices about the brand, what would be the things people, or what are the things people talk about, or what information do they give you concerning the brand? What should you do as the CEO? What is missing?
Oh.
What do they want to see? What are the wishes? Do they want the watches be smaller, bigger? Tell me a little bit what you hear.
You hear many stuff such as don't change anything, but like do more colors, like do more smaller, like do more ladies, like do more diamonds, like do more whatsoever. But Panerai stays Panerai, and we'll continue to make masculine sports watches, which have been primarily thought for divers. And that's why this year we have submersible, for example, as a theme, which we developed in many different materials like Carbotech, like BMG, like Bronzo. And next year will be the year of Luminor, where we'll continue the same approach of staying on the roots of the brand. There is no new range which is planned in the next many years. We don't intend to decrease the size of our dials. We don't intend to do
diamond watches. Did you hear that?
He's
not intending to decrease the sizes, because many of you have been asking, is he going?
Yeah, I know.
But you have some smaller watches.
We have 38. Millimeter watches in the dual
starting
collection.
At 38 and
38
up, going up to 50
up to, yeah 50 when you come
some
to
little
the,
pizzas for the
Egitiano and so on on Mare Nostrum. But basically at 38 we have a small watch, which is in our industry a big one, because very few brands start at 38 their assortment. And we don't see any trend whatsoever in the world of getting a demand towards smaller size brands, smaller size models. So we'll continue this approach of having 47, 42, more 42 the coming year, which will come in the landscape of the Luminor highlight. But Panerai stays for a big watch.
A masculine big
yes.
watch. Do you plan probably to have more technical watches also available in smaller sizes? Because people sometimes complain and say, oh, I would like to have the watch, it's so big. It's, is this...
Well, we the issue is that when you come to a complication, it's very often not associated to 300 meters water resistant. You know, if you have the 300 water resistance plus the complication, complicated to make a small watch out of that. So all complications will be based, like this one, for example, which is a 47 millimeter. It's always based on normally big cases. So however, all our models are mechanical.
In-house movements.
In-house movement. And we'll continue to do that on the 38 millimeter is part of this program.
Okay. Terms of movement, if you've just been talking about anything changing here, or anything you, you want to probably tell me?
Yes, next year, next year, a big highlight, we will launch the perpetual calendar. it will be a big highlight of the SIHH 2020. We'll have a big program on the Minor next year, and we'll be very pleased to have...
It's a completely new developed...
Totally new development made by our Laboratorio di Idee Neuchâtel.
Okay.
In Switzerland.
Okay, and Bill, can you tell me in which case?
No. Oh yeah, Luminor. Yeah,
it's only Luminor.
Luminor. Yeah.
Okay.
Luminor.
It's only in the Luminor.
Luminor. But it will be a pure Panerai aesthetic approach, and it will be unveiled the day of the SIHH.
You have been successfully introducing with me together on these adventure packages, and people now there were people saying, okay, this is the biggest bullshit they've ever seen. Okay, that's for them. But others have said, that's fantastic.
Yes.
Especially those things you can't buy because you have to get them, like the training with the special forces of the military. So how did those packages sell? Are they all sold out?
But you know, this, we never did that to sell them because we had a quantity of 67 pieces for the world. So when you take a country like Switzerland, I think we got here in Switzerland something like one or two customers who were able to be part of these experiences. So we sold them all before the SIHH because it was anyway a retail driven operation. We will start the first one with the Marina Militare early September. So we have 33 guests, and they all have confirmed they will come to be part of this operation to have the watch finally at the end of these 2 days of training with the military forces. It takes a lot of time to prepare because nobody in the Marina Militare has been organized to welcome 33 people to train with them. So we have to start from scratch. It's not like you plug the program to something existing. We have to develop everything from scratch. Then September we have the Guillaume Neri training in Tahiti, where also everybody is planned to come. And then later in the year, we have the Mike Horn expedition. But what I can tell you is that we have 3, 4, 5 times more demand than what we have offered as a limited edition program. But we want to make it very, that the people leave the experience with a memorable souvenir of what they've been doing. Or they can be ambassador of the brand for the next.
Since the thing seems to be successful, there's more to come.
More to come next year. We'll have 2 type of operations next year. On one side, the worldwide experiences, and the local experiences. When you have a celebrity which is very local, despite it's probably a world champion of something, and which will be dedicated to one nationality, and we'll unveil that at the next year, somewhere next year. I don't know yet when, but all the programs are packaged.
The packages will continue, and it's part of.
We'll have 6 programs next year instead of 3 this year. I think we have about 200 people who will be invited in these operations.
So all of you who have been very skeptical about these programs, you see, here you hear, you get the answer. Those things are successful.
That
I think
works.
People want that kind of, I don't know, extra fun, extra adventure, extra...
I was in Taiwan recently where someone even asked me, okay, I know the watches are not more available, but I would like to be part of the experience. So can I buy the experience?
Okay, only the experience, And which one did they want?
They wanted my Marina Militare. Yes. Which has got much more, success than we were planning, despite we have 33 pieces. And it will be probably the toughest in terms of physical conditions.
So
what we want is that everybody is back home safe. That's our main target.
They will be home safe.
I'm sure.
Okay, beside of this, anything else you heard in your little travels around the world? Special or something, announcement?
Well, we see a lot of the, or I try to see a lot of the Paneristi when I travel. I see a lot of people from the world of media, our trade partners. You know, Panerai is a brand which has got a lot of emotional impact on many communities. So we believe we are a brand of emotions on communities, and we are, our job when you are from headquarters is how you make sure that all these world are gravitating smoothly around the brand, or with the brand. Our manufacturer, which you know by heart, because you have been a couple of times, is doing very well. We will reopen Firenze, which is a good news. We'll reopen, not reopen, but we will make Firenze, which is our historical boutique, as everybody knows, a museum inside the boutique where you'll be able to go through the different location of the store, including the office of Mr. Panerai. Mm-hmm. And we'll mix historical timepieces not for sale with existing timepieces for sale. And that will open in 1 week time.
You are very much emotionalizing the brand, to inject emotions.
Well, we are a brand of sports, a brand of Italian soul. So if we are not
culture,
so if we are not
also having Italian water, so
exactly
everything is Italian. Even the sugar is written in Italian.
I'm sure. We normally serve you an aperitivo after 5 p.m. We welcome you normally with buongiorno everywhere you go in the world, in any of our stores. So we are a brand of emotions, of course, and that's our job to make it sure that the people understand when they enter a Panerai world that they are entering in a share of an Italian territory.
Okay. Last thing on the table, there's a very special watch.
Yes.
Because you just told me, and I didn't know this. On the occasion of opening a boutique, you always have some of the most wanted, looked after watches available. It's a Bronzo.
Exactly.
So if someone is seeing the video, for how long will this watch probably be available?
I'm sure it's already booked by someone here. In fact, the Bronzo is not available in many stores because when the product arrives, it's normally booked by a customer. But when we do a boutique opening, we have normally 2-3 Bronzo available to support the boutique launch and to create interest for our location. So today you're lucky because you can see one.
Yeah, I saw it. But if someone is looking now and says, okay, I want to get the watch, what must he do?
He come to a Panerai boutique somewhere in the world, including here in Zurich.
And he's saying, okay, I saw him on TV
and
he told me.
And basically,
I know him, and then
he gave his name, and I will give him a slot when the watch will be available for him. So he has a down payment to do. And based on that, then he is registered in our system.
Okay.
And we will not be able to tell him, you can get it today, but we can give him a date when he can get it.
So it's not it's kind of a waiting list, but a waiting list with a date.
Exactly, with a slot.
That's not bad.
Okay.
So did you get that, guys? So you can get the watch by putting yourself on a kind of a waiting list.
Exactly.
But you will exactly know when you get the watch.
Exactly.
And that's pretty different to many other brands because they say, okay, put you on a waiting list in 3 years, 4 years.
And then you don't know. Yes. Yeah. No, we try to be, many people have complained that the Bronzo was never available. And the issue is how you don't create frustration. How you create envy but not frustration. So we understand that there are some dates people are interested, Christmas, birthday, gifts, whatsoever.
So we try to
mitigate this type of constraints by giving the customers who are really interested.
But I imagine Christmas is a little bit difficult.
Well, because we have all our qualities which are already planned for the next 12 months.
So what will be an average waiting time?
I think that for Bronzo today, if you are, because we like to serve first our loyal customers, which are the first group of people we are serving. So I think that today you cannot get a Bronzo before summer 2020.
It's summer 2019?
Yes.
2019, so in 1 year.
Yes, you can get
it. Okay, that's okay.
I hope that you will not have 300 people coming today asking for Bronzo because then I will not be able to keep the lead time anymore.
But at least you are fair. You're giving them a date.
Yes.
That's very nice.
Yeah.
Okay, this is a Bronzo.
This is a Bronzo, 47 millimeter, yes, with a ceramic bezel.
Yeah. Great.
The last product we have in the Bronzo collection.
I can take 2 Panerais. Okay, mine is much older, so it's not one of the recent collections. Jean-Marc, thank you very much.
Thank you
for talking
pleasure.
To me. All the best for your store here on the Bahnhofstrasse.
Yeah.
And keep on injecting some emotions. I like you. I like the work you did with Roger Dubuis at the time. You were the guy who really, I was always admiring you. How can one be so creative and put so much stuff into a brand? And I think you're continuing your story a little bit with Panerai.
We have.
And I'm looking forward to see Panerai to be really, let's say, the first brand you touch and feel. It's not only, it's a touch and feel in terms of product and in terms of adventures and emotions. And really.
We have ideas for the next 1,000 years, I can promise you.
Okay. Let's stay fit 1,000 years to come with Panerai.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Guys, thanks for watching. If you like what we are doing, of course, please don't forget to subscribe to our video or the YouTube channel. And of course, also to like our videos and hit that bell so you get the notifications if something new is online. Bye-bye from Zurich and all the best to you guys. Bye.
Thank you.